I removed my professor from campus. I don't know if this is the best revenge story. In fact, I never really viewed this situation as revenge, so much as ensuring the person at fault did not repeat the same mistake again. Sadly, this revenge did not occur for 2 years, which was primarily because I did not come to terms with the events until that time. I am a people pleaser. I always have been, especially when it comes to school. I had a perfect GPA throughout high school and all of college. So when Dr. R, one of the English professors on campus, offered a job as his assistant to me, I leapt on the offer. My previous job as a college tutor was fine, but I had grown weary of the inconsistent hours, and I always enjoyed Dr. R's infamously difficult classes. The work-study job started simply. I helped grade essays and was even able to conduct research and gave a lecture when he was unable to come to class. Overall, I enjoyed it. Then came the shift. I was and still am a recovering bulimic. I had bulimia since 7th grade, and it landed me in the hospital with potassium levels at 1.7 during the fall semester of 2017. Dr. R learned of the incident, and he told me to stop by his house on the way home from the hospital so he could give me some homemade ramen. I did as he asked, and he gave me a tight hug the moment he saw me, expressing his worries and stressing that I never let something like that happen to me again. Thus, he became one of my accountability partners. Dr. R was doting. He would bring chai tea to work for me alongside other calming drinks for my stomach. He would also do other small actions. A brush over my hand when handing papers. Moving my hand to his shoulder once when he was upset. Etc. I would shrug it off because of his insisting we were friends alongside my own inability to believe in any other possibilities for the relationship. Thus, when Dr. R invited me to dinner, as colleagues, citing the end of the semester, I didn't think anything of it and stupidly agreed. The dinner was December 12, 2017. I remember that date clearly because it was the second anniversary of my dad's death, which the professor had acknowledged on that day. It wasn't until he placed his hand on my leg in the car that I realized. And I tightened my gut and stiffly went along with the date. We ate sushi, and the conversation remained cordial. We finished dinner, and the mortification of being on a date with my professor continued to grow within me. People at the restaurant kept sending us tight smiles at the obvious age difference. The professor has graying hair while I already have difficulties not being mistaken for a high schooler. Thus, when Dr. R asked if I wanted to be dropped off at my dorm, I, once again very stupidly, I was extremely naive, said no. I would rather walk the block from his house to mine. I was blaming myself already for agreeing on the dinner, and I didn't know how to back out of it. So I figured that it was an event I had to grit my teeth through and smile over. We arrived at his house, and he insisted I come inside in spite of my trying to say that I didn't have time and needed to return to the dorm and study. I relented and asked to go to the restroom. I remember going to his restroom, and my stomach rejected all of the sushi I had eaten after 2 weeks of clean behavior. Candles were set across his coffee table when I returned, and Dr. R placed an arm around me and tried to encourage me to agree to dating. I tried to express that I didn't want to, and so I said I would rather not date anyone until after college. Dr. R said he knew that would result in nothing happening. I said I was still uncertain. Dr. R tried to kiss me. I gained enough of a voice to stop him, and Dr. R relented, only to place a kiss on my forehead. My stomach dropped, and I began to worry of what would happen if I couldn't leave. Thankfully, my mom texted me, asking why I hadn't answered my phone. I leapt on that as an excuse to leave. And then I insisted on walking back to my dorm rather than being driven, for the fresh air, I insisted. Dr. R let me leave. But not without saying that I needed to give him an answer on dating by tomorrow. I cried on the way to my dorm. And my sister, who was my roommate, rubbed my back when she noticed I was in a poor mood. I managed to tell Dr. R that I was uninterested in dating the next day. After which I abruptly left my work-study position. Which somehow shocked him. He continued to send me texts and emails throughout the next year. None of which I responded to. After some time, Dr. R even got my mom involved. He convinced her I was interested. And more than once she would try to talk to me about making amends with him. He would try to get pictures of me. My mom took a while to finally understand that he was lying. After which she apologized profusely to me. But it took some time for our relationship to mend. I didn't report this incident to the university for the next 2 years due to my assumption that the I was at fault for leading him on. Now for the revenge, or rather, something I should have done when this event first occurred. There were rumors of Dr. R having a relationship with another student. The said student was a 19-year-old. And to say I was livid upon learning of this is an understatement. The girl had evidently agreed to a relationship with the professor. And she left the college when rumors circulated following other professors noticing the student's car at Dr. R's house and more than one occasion. My mom no longer contacted Dr. R by this point. Yet he emailed her one day and told her to warn me if any university officials came to ask questions. He also told her to let me know I had no reason to be jealous. And that he and this student were now engaged. My anger grew. Yet I did not want to cause a scene when I had 1 week left until graduation. It was a small town. And I didn't want there to be a rumor that I did anything immoral for my perfect GPA. As selfish as such a worry was, I knew that was the false assumption other students would make. Thus, I waited until it was closer to graduation and emailed the professor to ask if the rumors were true. And I asked for one good reason not to report him outside of whatever philosophical bullcrap he usually pulled from his rear. The email was more of my fuming about how I was foolish to assume he would not prey on other English students again. And I was planning on reporting him either way. He confirmed the rumors. And I sent my testimony alongside every email I had of the professors to the Dean of Students less than 5 minutes after receiving my diploma. My mom sent all of the emails the professor sent to her in the past as well. And Dr. R was off campus in less than 48 hours. No one in the university's county was willing to hire him after that. And he had to return to his parents for a while before finding a stable job. Most of his friends in the area, alongside many students I graduated with, shunned him. And there was some celebration from those who worried of his upper-level courses in which they would normally have to read 30 books. Dr. R did marry the student. But he no longer works at a university. The fact of which I am grateful for. Some people have disagreed with my actions in this situation and have tried to argue that relationships with a professor are okay. But I believe they don't see the manipulation that I didn't notice until over a year after the incident. So thankful you got out of that. It was so not okay. It was predatory and putting you in the most uncomfortable of situations, using your past as a means to get close to you. Fuck him and people like him. It was technical grooming. He didn't make it clear that it was a date. He was touching you without permission, making you uncomfortable, and trying to manipulate the situation. Good on you for reporting him and doing the right thing. So this professor was basically grooming you and the 19 years old. Well done. I'm very proud of you for reporting him. And don't blame you for your previous hesitation. Learning experiences are situations that suck but help you figure out what to do next time. Sounds like Dr. Doom than Dr. R. As a professor, let me thank you for coming forward. Thankfully, situations like this don't happen very often. But when they do, the department usually has suspicions. Unfortunately, you can't fire a tenured professor just for having suspicions. So nothing can be done until someone comes forward. So people think a gray-haired professor dating a 19-year-old student is normal. That's like the opposite of normal, and adding to the fact that he ignored your discomfort and clear requests for him to stop and even asked your mom for pictures of you when you clearly said no was bordering on harassment, he got what he deserved. He ignored the fact that you said no and tried to pick you up. And the fact that people in your community think a gray-haired man dating a 19-year-old girl is normal shows that that community is not a good one at all. He got what he deserved for making advances in you when you said no. The people normalizing such a relationship with that much of an age gap really need some mental help. Kudos for reporting this, regardless of the age difference. The simple fact is he held a position of power over you and used that to manipulate you. This would still have been despicable even had you been close to the same age. People, and I use that term loosely, like that should never be allowed to hold positions of authority. No, what's not okay was that he was trying to force a relationship and was grooming you. That's disgusting, and I hope that girl that he's with now is okay and that she gets away from him. Good on you for getting his ass fired. What he did was wrong on so many levels. He was grooming and sexually harassing TIY. That you were his student, which put him a position of power, makes it even more despicable what he did. And it doesn't stop there. He knew you struggled with bulimia, which he actively used to comfort you and help you in order to make you feel like you owed him. The man is a predator. Simple at that. He deserves a much bigger shitstorm than you threw at him. But what I hope mostly is that you are doing okay now and are living a happy life. Student-professor relationship is unambiguously sexual misconduct, and this professor really should have landed themselves some jail time. It does not matter if both people are adults. If one has a position of power over the other, it is sexual misconduct. Additionally, this is grooming and just super gross. That man is a predator. The minute he found out you were in treatment, he started grooming you. You did nothing wrong. Good for you. Good for you. Absolutely incredible response. I'm so sorry he put you and others in that horrible situation. He abused the imbalance in the power dynamic to prey on young women. I hope you don't beat yourself up for any part of your reactions, because it's all very understandable and logical. You did an excellent and brave thing by reporting him. I don't know you personally, but I am so proud of you. You made a big difference in an innumerable number of girls' lives, including your own, I'm sure. Personally, if two people are both interested and they both make their intentions known, the relationship is fine and I wish them all the best. But this guy? No. He's a damned pedophile, or at least what my mom would call a putz. Inviting you to a date without mentioning or making it clear that it's a date. Unwanted, touching, and uncomfortable situations. Nah. Dude's a pedo. He deserved it. Who says relationships between students and faculty are okay? That's crazy. A person in a position of power taking advantage of someone younger is wrong. A sixth grade teacher raping one of her students is wrong. Same applies in college level. Even if the student doesn't take that professor's classes. Good on you for standing up to that creep. Just because you and the 19-year-old are legal, doesn't mean he didn't use his position to basically groom you. Here's hoping for the best in your career, beer mugs. I had thought to wade in, but by trying to be fair, all I see in this is a shitload of downvotes for myself, so I will post this remark instead.
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epic Aracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.